All right, so I got the motor set in this thing, the trans bolted up and the body set on. There's the trans, good old Muncie. So I had a change of plans on how I was gonna mount the motor, so now I'm gonna build a motor cross member. So I gotta run and get material for that. And material to do the trans cross member and material to do the motor mount plates, because I made these right here that we're gonna bolt onto the side of the motor, but they're just not thick enough, I don't think, for the torque that thing's probably gonna be making. So I'm gonna get some quarter inch and do that instead. So yeah, gonna go to my favorite metal spot in Englewood, C&M. If you guys are in the Denver area, Tom and Tommy, father and son guys, they own and run the place. Super good dudes. So yeah, hit them up if you need metal. Look what showed up yesterday. We got our own stomp shear now. It's a brand new Grizzly one. I think the length is 52 inches. So yeah, I could put a 4-foot sheet in here, no problem. Like if I need to shear up a 4x8, which is usually what sheets come in. Capacity of 16 gauge in steel, and pretty sure it'll do 3/16 aluminum, but super stoked to have that. You know, I've been lacking in the equipment department for a while, and you know, now getting a tube bender and a notcher and a shear, and I got my MIG welder and my TIG welder next door and an air compressor, like it's finally to the point where I can like actually make money fabricating instead of wasting a bunch of time with like cut off wheels and like having to go other places to have stuff bent and just all kinds of crap. So I'm stoked to finally be getting like some real pieces of equipment in here. Equipment next, I need to get a brake, like a box pan brake, and I'm also getting a bead roller because I'm going to need those two items to do the floor and the firewall on Kevin's hot rod next door. So I just don't know where the hell we're going to put it though. Our shop's like already maxed out. Like, stand back over here, like we literally have 40 pounds of shit in a 10 pound bag right now. It's pretty wild.
Will it fit first try? Let's find out. Oh, so close. Alright, so back at it on Kevin's car today. Show you what I got going on and what I got done yesterday. So, got the engine cross member welded in, got the motor leveled out, got the chassis leveled, and also made these engine mount plates. So the plan with these is I got these bushings from four-wheel parts. So a bushing goes in it and then a sleeve, and then I'm gonna weld tabs down on the cross member that are gonna have a bolt passing through this. And then I got this guy coped to fit that. Pretty nice cope. And then that's gonna weld on here. So it's gonna be pretty sweet. Gonna be super stout. I mean, look at it, it's all, this is probably chromoly and this is DOM, and that's just mild steel because that's not super important, but it's gonna look badass all TIG welded up. So I'll do a little time lapse of TIG welding that for you, and then installed. just gotta let them cool and then tack them to the motor plates on the engine. And now I got these tacked together, so I'm gonna do another time lapse of finish welding those up and then putting the bushings in and making the tabs and doing the final install on those. Welded to the engine plates. Looks pretty good. I wish I had a water-cooled torch. That thing gets hot as fuck, especially when you're welding thick stuff of like 140 amps. So, future upgrades for sure. But for now, I'll get by with doing shit like this.
Woo, that's that fire.
So yeah, motor mounts are done. Motor's pretty level. Yeah, now on to the trans mount. Do a happy dance. Dance, Billy, dance. Dance, dance, dance. Motherfucking dance. So, Billy just helped me. It's like 10:30 now, and we just finished up the trans cross member and trans mount on this thing. Turned out pretty sweet. What I did for this was I TIG welded weld nuts into the frame, and then that way the cross member bolts in, and TIG welded as much as I could. There was a contamination issue on the problem, so I ended up having to MIG weld the bottoms of these, but used a universal energy suspension transmission bushing or transmission mount, and then TIG welded up a mount for that on the cross member. Turned out real good. So now that the power plant and transmission and everything is mounted in the frame, here's the mount on this side. I'm going to take the grease zerk out and just TIG that hole closed, because you don't really need to grease your engine mount.
What?
Blasphemy. So yeah, and all stainless steel hardware on this thing. All the suspension is going to have stainless steel. The transmission's going to be all stainless steel, and the bell housing is going to be, haven't changed that yet, but we want the hardware to be, you know, something that stands out on this as being really nice. And I hate hex cap screws, so we're using socket head cap screws on everything. I'm just having an issue finding 5/8 stainless fine thread ones for the steering, but other than that, it's coming right along. Kevin, the owner, he's going to be super stoked on this thing when he sees it in person. Oop.
Kaboom!
Blam! Team to support your effort. We got a pretty dope setup here watching Formula D, or Pro 2. Who are you rooting for?
Danny George.
Danny George? I'm rooting for Josh Robinson for obvious reasons. Because he's in a truck. I think that's pretty fucking sick. But yeah, we're just chilling now. Wanted to thank you guys. Channel just hit 2,000 subscribers. Thanks to everyone that's watching and, you know, subscribing and, you know, paying attention to the videos. And to all the people in there just talking shit in the comments, you know, because your life sucks or whatever, I feel bad for you. A lot of hate in the comments. I don't know. Some of you people, I don't even know, man. But, you know, channel's growing. I'm happy. Me and Billy chilling. We're just waiting for Mike to get here with Karen's car. And in the meantime, we're going to enjoy some drifting. See you more. Therefore.